Good morning. This week's collective worship is all about Black History Month, and Miss Benji from the History Department is here to tell us more. So, Miss Benji, what is Black History Month?
Black History Month is what we celebrate in October in the UK. It is our chance to discuss the contributions of Black and minority ethnic groups and what they have done during the history of Britain.
So, why do we need a whole month to talk about Black history?
Sometimes when we talk about history, we don't take into account all the different people, cultures, and communities that have been in the UK throughout time. In Black History Month, we are taking the time to make sure that we speak about the experiences of everybody who lives in our country, and not just the people who maybe have been in charge or won the wars.
And what are some of the main events in Black history that we particularly try and remember during this month?
So, because we are studying mostly British history, we are looking at the lives of people in Britain and making sure we talk about the experiences of everyone. So that's going back to the lives of the Romans and recognising that we have people of African descent living in Roman Britain. We can talk about the lives of people from other ethnic groups during the Tudors and the impact of England on the slave trade. And in more modern history, we can talk about the impact of post-war immigration and how, as the empire dissolved, people of many different nationalities came and moved to Britain to form our mixed and diverse culture today.
And finally, during Black History Month, what can we do as a school to better support diversity in our community?
We should always make sure that we are letting other voices be heard, as everyone has a different story to tell about their experiences in our community. We should challenge what we hear in the news and read widely to make sure we have the most accurate information when we start talking about the experiences of others.
Racial equality and Black history are issues that God cares about a lot. You'll probably have seen on the news over the last few months that there's been this huge movement called Black Lives Matter, and this was kind of started by something that happened a few months ago, where a man named George Floyd, who was a Black American man, was killed by police. And it started a series of protests and demonstrations and people trying to let the world know that Black Lives Matter. Now, as a statement, Black Lives Matter is 100% true, and it's 100% biblical. It's something that Jesus believes is true. And I'm pretty sure that if Jesus were here on earth today, he would be at the front of those picket lines, at the front of those demonstrations, and he would be shouting that Black Lives Matter. Jesus was a Middle Eastern man. He wasn't born into a family that was very rich, and he was all about the outcast, the persecuted, and the poor. His whole life was about justice and caring for those that other people look down on. If you think about who was actually there at his birth, you've got the foreigner, that's the wise men, and the poor, that's the shepherds. And if you think about who was there at his death, the most important event in history, when he was resurrected, the people who witnessed that resurrection first were two women. And at this time, it was a time when the witness of a woman was not really counted as valid. In the Bible, God says that he made all people in his image, that he loves all people, that all people are precious to him, that all people are his treasured possession. That's how he sees every single one of us, regardless of colour, regardless of background, regardless of wealth, regardless of how other people see you. We're just going to finish this collective worship this morning by watching a video of the dance troupe Diversity, who you might have seen on Britain's Got Talent, doing a dance to the song Black Lives Matter by Dax, and it's a really powerful performance. Listen to the lyrics really carefully.
No Nobody's born racist, man. It's something you learn deep rooted in your brain from the day of your birth. I think it's time that we repair all of these bridges we burned and let love out of our hearts onto the cheeks we've turned. Spread love, show love. Let's get rid of this curse. Don't wait for anyone to act. Man, you go first. 400 years wasted. Let's get rid of this hurt, because that's the only way we'll ever see peace on earth. In our time, everybody's fighting change coming. Yes, that's why it's an acronym for riot. Everybody has a voice. Don't you dare stay silent. If you say nothing, you are an accessory to violence. Let these words fed the tears of our people that are crying. We can bring back hope, but not the people that are dying. It's what happens when the people you've oppressed ask for change in the country that they built, but you've ignored and denied. This is Sandra Bland, George Floyd, and every single family. Police brutality is intervened in and destroyed. Couple bad cops can't define all you other boys. So every good cop needs to stand up and make some noise. Black, white, Asian, doesn't matter, cause we can't avoid. So let's all come together, join hands, and yes, get annoyed at people who believe racism makes sense in a country built on minorities, slaves, work employees. Nobody's born racist, man. It's something you learn deep rooted in your brain from the day of your birth. I think it's time that we repair all of these bridges we burned and let love out of our hearts onto the cheeks we've turned. Spread love, show love. Let's get rid of this curse. Don't wait for anyone to act. Man, you go first. 400 years wasted. Let's get rid of this hurt, cause that's the only way we'll ever see peace on earth.
Let's pray. If you want to join in, you can say Amen at the end, and you might want to close your eyes. Father God, I thank you that you love and value everyone the same. I thank you that we are all counted as your children. Help us to love our neighbour as we love ourselves in the way that you have commanded. Amen.